We're just about to set off into the middle of the Sahara Desert, and you know, not a great time to be getting the spanners out, to be honest. The belt's been dragging into the mechanism, and that's bent some metal, and you know, obviously if we carry on, we're going to shag the engine. Excuse my French.
The expedition limps into camp for the night. Gilo's flying car is a prototype and is the only one in the world. Many of the engine parts have been built especially for it. Repairing a fault is fraught with difficulties. It's serious, and the entire engine has to be stripped out to get to the offending part.
I think ultimately I've been taken out of my element, suddenly plunked in the middle of the desert where things, you know, can go wrong. Problems come up, the machine starts breaking down, you've got to solve them, you know, bodging things up wherever possible, all the things that I sort of like to do really carefully and meticulously, thrown out of the window. Seriously, looking quite sorry for itself, isn't it?
There's a hard chance, bro.
Yeah, exactly.
The problem is worse than the ever-optimistic Gilo first thought.
It's really, really not good news, actually. We were all looking at me, Toby and Ben, were looking at this thing intently, thinking, you know, what is the best way to solve this problem?
Took the end of that off.
Expedition mechanic Ben is used to dealing with these kinds of problems.
Ben just looked at it and said, well, hold on, why don't you just not use that bit and put it the other way around? And I was like, actually, yeah, that's a really good point. Of course you can. That's really cool.
It's not a perfect seal, but it creates a dust shield.
So that's brilliant, good idea. Yeah, really good idea. Yeah, that's a great idea. Let's just do that.
It's 1 month and over 3,500 miles since the expedition left London. Gilo, Ben and Toby have worked through the night to get the car repaired and try to keep their expedition on schedule.
I think we've mended it now, we hope. Made some new bits in the desert. So it's, you know, it's the best we can do with the good bit we've got to make it drive and fly still.
Neil and Gilo plan to fly across a nearby landmark to demonstrate that the sky car can take two people at altitude. Ben Amira is an enormous monolith towering 300 metres above the desert floor. Conditions are perfect for flying, but both are worried about the extra weight.
Every kilo we reduce in weight means better performance. And obviously on this particular flight, my considerations as pilot, I've got 80 kilos of gyro, probably 2 or 3 kilos of sand. So those are my immediate concerns for this particular flight.
Despite full revs, their combined weight is too much, and Neil is forced to abandon the takeoff.
She's too heavy for two people. It's a shame, but we could get two people off the ground, no problem, if we had the prop drive spot on, but it needs improvement. So at the moment, it's a two-man car and a one-man aircraft. It was, at the beginning, the front wheels are off the ground, but Neil...
Stopped just in time.
Can you imagine that? Well, another 10 feet more, we would have had a paraglider wrapped up in train.
There's only one way to decide who flies to Ben Amira.
One, two, three. I'm afraid I win.
Okay, but you'll get the next flight.
Yeah.
You'll get the next
flight. No problem, sir. Don't worry, that was fair as fair can be. Go for it.
Reduced weight in the car has done the trick, and Neil takes off without a hitch. 32 days since the expedition left London, and they're moving into remote territory now. Every army marches on its stomach, and making sure the 10-man support team of motorbike outriders, drivers and mechanics has enough food is a priority.
We're just negotiating to buy a medium-sized goat so that we've got some food to eat for the team. That appears to be the unfortunate victim.
Berber nomads spend their whole lives crisscrossing the Sahara with their herds. The opportunity to make some money is a welcome one.
He must have wondered what the hell was going on with. It's not like Sainsbury's.
Yeah, give him the head.
They offer to skin and gut the animal using age-old methods.
Hey!
Fantastic. No worries.
This is a life, isn't it? Popcorn, parrot, and a goat.
One goat.
Oh, it smells delicious.
Does it smell good?
Yeah. Now this is proper bush good wine.
Mon Dieu, delicious. Enjoy.
Mm. The expedition has been traversing the Sahara for 9 days. The still air of the early morning mean conditions couldn't be better for flying. Gilo wants to fly his creation for the first time since England, but is suffering from a little pre-flight nerves.
I haven't flown the flying car for 4 months. Neil's done all the flying since then, so I got a bit nervous about the whole thing, you know, thinking, God, you know, how controllable is it going to be and all these things. And you know, you sort of build up in your mind all these sort of different scenarios.
OK, Gilo, we'll meet you in Chigeti.
OK. Yeah.
You've got the coordinates in your GPS, and have a lovely flight.
Sort of transition whereby you're used to being in a car and it's bumping along and it's quite noisy and, you know,
and then all of a sudden as the wheels go light, the front comes up,
and then literally you start feeling that everything starts getting light, so the steering wheel starts becoming really sort of easy to move,
you know, you feel a little weightlessness, and all of a sudden, you know, there's still noise, but there's less noise than there was before.
The noise stops suddenly. The noise, the rumbling, the tyres and all that kind of stuff suddenly goes.
There's tranquility and peace as you start climbing away into the air.
It's the most beautiful flight I've had for years. Absolutely stunning. The landscape here is incredible, far more exciting and interesting than I ever anticipated it would be. It's just absolutely stunning.